To Through the Bible. We are listening to the stories of the kings in the southern kingdom of Judah. King Jehoiakim burns Jeremiah's scroll. 2 Kings chapters 23 and 24. After the wicked reign of King Amon, King Josiah was crowned king. He loved and obeyed the Lord. During his reign, the book of God's law, which was thought to have been lost, was found in the temple. Josiah made sure it was read to the people of Judah. God raised a prophet called Jeremiah to preach that unless they repented and obeyed, then God would send the Babylonians to take them as captives. Urged on by Josiah, Jeremiah and others, false idols and places of occult worship were smashed, but the people did not turn back to God with all their hearts. Josiah went into battle against Pharaoh Necho II and was fatally wounded by Egyptian archers. He was brought back to Jerusalem to die. Pharaoh Necho II intervened to put Eliakim on the throne in his place and changed his name to Jehoiakim. He would act as a puppet king to do what the Egyptians wanted, and the people of Judah would pay the Egyptians tribute money. Jehoiakim worshipped false gods and became a godless tyrant who committed atrocious sins and crimes. The nation turned away from God, and the prophet Jeremiah warned it was foolish to trust in the Egyptians to defend them. He preached that unless they repented, the Babylonians would invade and take them captive. Three years after becoming king, Jehoiakim heard the news that the Egyptians had been defeated by the Babylonians at the Battle of Carchemish in 605 BC. God told Jeremiah to write down all the prophecies he had given him over many years. A scribe called Baruch wrote down God's words on a scroll as Jeremiah dictated them to him. The Babylonian king Nebuchadnezzar swooped down the coast near Jerusalem to capture the Philistine cities controlled by Egypt. When Baruch had finished writing the scroll, Jeremiah said, "I am forbidden to go into the temple. On the next day of fasting, when the people of Judah are in the temple, read the words of this scroll to them." Baruch went into the room just off the upper assembly hall of the temple and read God's word to the crowd. Baruch was then invited to read the scroll to some of the top leaders. By the time he finished, the leaders were severely frightened. "We must tell the king," they said. But they told Baruch and Jeremiah to go into hiding, as they knew the king would not be pleased. The scroll was taken to King Jehoiakim, in the winter apartment of his palace. He had a fire burning to keep him warm. Jehudi began reading the scroll to the king. As Jehudi read each section, the king cut that section off the scroll. King Jehoiakim then burnt that section in the fire. He repeated this until the whole scroll was burnt to cinders. Elnathan, Delaiah, and Gemariah pleaded with the king not to burn the scroll, but he wouldn't listen to them. He had nothing but contempt for God's warnings. Two men were sent to arrest Jeremiah and Baruch, but God had hidden them. King Nebuchadnezzar defeated the Philistine city of Ashkelon and headed towards Jerusalem. Jehoiakim decided to surrender to King Nebuchadnezzar rather than see the Babylonians destroy the city. He changed his allegiance from the Egyptians to the Babylonians. He paid the Babylonians tribute from the treasury and gave them valuable artifacts from the temple. Some of the royal family and nobility were handed over to the Babylonians as hostages. Jehoiakim continued to reign for another 3 years as a vassal king in the Babylonians. God told Jeremiah to dictate the words of the burnt scroll to Baruch again. A second scroll was written, which is in our Bible today, in the book of Jeremiah. In 601 BC, the Babylonians tried to invade Egypt and were beaten back. Against all the warnings of Jeremiah, King Jehoiakim switched allegiance back to the Egyptians. For 3 years, the Babylonians did nothing. Then, in 598 BC, they moved in to deal with the rebellious king. Jerusalem was surrounded and people inside trapped. The siege went on for 3 months. During the siege, King Jehoiakim died. The people inside the city threw the king's dead body over the city wall, hoping the Babylonians would show them mercy. Jehoiakim's body lay on the ground until the siege ended. Jehoiakim's son, Jeconiah, also known as Jehoiachin, was crowned king, but once the city fell, the Babylonians deposed him and took him prisoner. King Nebuchadnezzar took 10,000 captives from Jerusalem, including all the princes and the best of the soldiers, craftsmen, and smiths. So only the poorest and least skilled people were left in the land. The king of Babylon appointed King Jehoiachin's great uncle Mattaniah to be the next king, and he changed his name to Zedekiah.